Animated typography is very important in video editing process, so let me show you how you can create this minimal looking typography animation inside of DaVinci Resolve. It is going to be a step-by-step tutorial, so watch this video till the end, and I am also gonna show you how you can save and use the preset in different projects. Let's go. Alright guys, again here we are on DaVinci Resolve 18.6, and before we start, all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner, set the size of this project 1920x1080, select a frame rate. So in this case I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation. Click on save. Now I'm gonna make this animation inside of the Fusion page, so we have to take a new Fusion composition first, which is very important. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new Fusion composition. You can call it anything, whatever you like. Duration, make it 5 seconds long, frame rate 60, click on create. And this is the Fusion composition. Drag and drop the Fusion composition on the timeline, and then you can go to the Fusion page. Here we have the media out node. You can drag and drop the media out to the side for now. And let's start by creating a background. So this is the background node. Drag and drop the background to the flow window. If you want to take a preview of this background, simply drag and drop the background to the viewer and you can get the preview like this. Perfect. Now let's change the color of the background. Simply go to the inspector window, go to the color and select a gray color. Hit OK. You can also put the value manually. So this is the red, green, blue value. So I'm going to set the value 0.06 in red, green, blue, like this. And we will get this type of gray color. Perfect. And after that, we have to create a new shape layer. So for that, we will use background node. So this is the background. We will use the background as a shape. So just right click on that, click on rename, or you can also hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. I'm gonna call it shape. So this is the shape layer. Now let's attach a rectangle with it. So this is the rectangle. Drag and drop the rectangle to the viewer. Attach the rectangle with the shape layer and make it a square shape. So here we have the width and height. So I'm gonna set the width value 0.5 and height value 0.85. Perfect. And this is the corner radius. I'm gonna set the value 0.5. And this is the solid option. So uncheck the solid and make it like this. And then here we have the border width. You can increase the border width and set the border width something around 0.07. And then we have to change the color of the shape layer. So this is the shape node. Select this node, which is the background node, and then go to inspector window. Just go to type and change this type to gradient. Select the first color, maybe like this, and select the end color, maybe orange. Hit OK. Perfect. And after that, we will attach a color corrector node to change the color of the shape layer. So simply select this node, add a CC color corrector, drag and drop to the viewer, go to inspector window, and here we have the hue. You can change the hue value to change the color of the shape layer like this. Perfect. And after that, we will attach a transform node. So select the color corrector, add a transform, and I'm going to use this transform to animate the shape. So simply drag and drop the transform to the viewer. Here we have to do some setting. Let's increase the size of the shape layer. I'm gonna set the value 1.5 in the size, and this is the angle. Let's change the angle, set it 44 degree, and this is the center. We will animate the center. So I'm gonna set the center X value 0.32, center Y 0.4. Perfect. Now we have to lock the position at frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second according to 60 frames per second. Right click on center, click on animate, or you can also click on the diamond button to create a keyframe, and then just go to very beginning of this animation. You can drag this shape outside of the frame like this. You can put the value negative 0.5. Perfect. Now just hold this position for 15 frames. So just go to frame number 75, click on the diamond button to lock the position, and then just go to 1 second forward in time on the frame number 135. Now you can drag it to the left hand side just a bit. You can set the value 0.22 in center X. Perfect. So basically we will get this type of linear animation. Now let's make this animation smoother. Just go to spline window, check this option, hit F4, click on the fit button. Here we have to do one by one, so select these two keyframes first, hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on the smooth button, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve, and repeat the same thing for these two keyframes. Now you can close the spline window and take a look. So here we have smooth animation. Perfect. After that, we have to merge this shape layer with this background. So drag and drop the background right over here. Take a new merge node. I'm gonna connect the yellow background point with this background, green foreground point with this transform one. Drag and drop the merge one to the viewer. And here we have something like this. Perfect. Now we have to do one more thing. Just change the gradient points. So select the shape layer. Hold control and scroll down to zoom out. Here we have two different gradient points. You can place the gradient point anywhere you want and create a unique gradient color using these two gradient points. Just like this. Once done, you can click on fit button. Perfect. And after that, we have to create a text, which is very important. So this is the text node. Drag and drop the text on the flow window. You can merge this text with the background by taking a new merge, but let me show you another way. It's very simple. Simply, you can connect the foreground layer output with the background layer output and you will get a new merge. Simply drag and drop the merge to the viewer and now the text is merged with the background. Simply select the text and type anything whatever you like. Select your favorite font style. So in this case, I am using Gotham font style. Of course, you can select any font style that you like. I'm gonna select the style medium. This is the size. Keep it 0.08. Tracking 0.95. And this is the line spacing. We don't have to do anything. Click on the edge anchor left. And then just right click on the preview window. Go to guide and turn on this guide like this. You can increase the size of the preview window. Here you can place the text right over here using this guide like this. After that, we have to animate the text. It's very simple. What you have to do, just take a new rectangle tool and connect the rectangle with the text. You can see the text inside of the rectangle box, as you can see. So we have to create a rectangular shape according to the text. You can zoom in by holding control and scroll up, and you can place it like this. After that, we have to animate the text. So select the text node, go to frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second. Go to layout, and this is the center. Right click on center, click on animate, go to frame number 30 and drag the text outside of the box that we have created. As you can see, now you can see the text inside of the box like this. And this is the animation. Perfect. So this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. This time we have to check the text one only, so uncheck the transform one, click on fit button, highlight these two keyframes, hit S, hold this handle and place the handle right over here and create a smooth graph. Close the spline window. Perfect. Now you can see here we have animation like this. Perfect. After that, we have to create a duplicate of this text. So select these two nodes, hold Ctrl C on the keyboard to copy, click over here and hit Ctrl V to paste another copy, and you can rename it properly. Now we have to merge the second text with the main output. So simply connect the output of this text node with the output of this merge, and you can get the new merge. Drag and drop to the viewer. After that, we have to move the text right over here. So it's very simple. Select the second text, add a transform, and by using this transform, you can drag the text right over here. You can also use this anchor point to move the text like this, and then you can change the text. So select the text, type anything whatever you like, just like this. And I'm gonna change the style of the text, maybe bold. Perfect. And now you can click on fit button, So here we have something like this, but both text are revealing at same time, so we have to create a time gap between both the lines. So what we have to do, just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. This time we need only text 2, so uncheck the text 1, highlight these two keyframes, just go to 15 frame forward in time. So right now our keyframe is starting from frame number 30, so we have to place the first keyframe at frame number 45, and this one is on frame number 75. So simply just go to 15 frame forward in time, highlight both the keyframes, hold this keyframe, hold shift on the keyboard and drag it like this. Now we have a time gap of 15 frame between both the lines. After that, we have to do one more thing. Simply take a new text node, connect the third text with the main output, drag and drop the merge 4 to the viewer, and select your font style. I'm gonna select the style medium maybe, and this is the size. First of all, let's set the size 0.02. perfect, and type anything whatever you like. So in this case, I want to type a description over here, so let's type a description just like this. And then here we have the line spacing. Just increase the line spacing like this, set the value 1.8 I guess, and this is the tracking. Increase the tracking just a little bit, so I'm going to set the value 1.05. perfect, and you can place the description over here. I'm going to down the size just a little bit. Perfect. Now let's animate the description line. So it's very simple. Just go to frame number 120, which is equal to 2 seconds. This is the end. Right click on end, click on animate, go to frame number 60, and let's set the end value 0. So we will get this type of typing animation as you can see. All right, now just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. Uncheck the text 2, check the text 3, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth. So basically we have something like this. Perfect. And after that we have to create transition. So what we have to do, let's take a new background node. I'm gonna call it matte. Attach a rectangle with this matte like this. I'm going to set the width value 1, height value 1, and then we have to merge this matte with the main output. So place the matte over here, take a new merge node. I'm going to use this matte as a background and this output as a foreground. So connect the yellow background point with this matte, green foreground point with this merge 4, and drag and drop the merge 5 to the viewer. Select the merge, go to operator, change this over to in, and then you can animate the rectangle. So just go to frame number 30, which is equal to 0.5 seconds. Right click on center, click on animate in the inspector window for the rectangle 4, and then just go to very first frame. Let's drag the rectangle. You can set the value -0.5. perfect. And then just go to frame number 270, lock the position by creating a keyframe, and then just go to the end of this animation, drag the rectangle in upper direction, and this time I'm gonna set the value 1.5. perfect. So basically we have this type of animation in and the animation out, but again we have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen, click on fit button. This time I want this rectangle 4, so uncheck the rectangle 3, check the rectangle 4 only, highlight these two keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve, highlight these two keyframes, hit S, hold this handle and create nice smooth curve like this. Perfect. Now we have transition on the typography, and then we have to do one more thing. We have to create a gap between the transition and the main animation. So what we have to do, just uncheck the rectangle 4 and check all the nodes like this, click on fit button, highlight all the keyframes and move it 15 frame forward in time. So just go to frame number 15 or maybe frame number 30. Hold the keyframe, hold shift and move it on frame number 30. And now you can see here we have transition and then the main text animation. After that you can attach a motion blur node if you have. So I have DaVinci Resolve Studio and I'm gonna search for motion blur. So this is the motion blur effect. Select the motion blur, drag and drop to the viewer. This is an optional step. If you don't have this motion blur effect in the free version, this is not important, so you can leave it. And then you can connect the output of this motion blur with the media out. And now we have the animation. Perfect. You can switch the color by using this color corrector node like this. So you can select any color whatever you like. And now let me show you how you can save this as a preset. So leave the media out as it is. Select all the nodes, right click on that, click on setting and click on save as. Select a location. In this case I will select desktop. Let's call it typography. Click on save and then you can go to the edit page and here we have our main text animation. And let me show you how you can use that preset. It's very simple. Suppose you are working on a new project. So just go to the project window, right click on that, click on new fusion composition, create a new fusion composition, duration make it 5 seconds long, frame rate 60, click on create, drag and drop the new fusion composition on the timeline and place it on your video clip if you want, or you can place it like this. Place the CTI right over here on the new fusion composition, go to fusion page. Just drag and drop the media out to the side. Simply go to the folder and drag and drop the typography setting on the flow window. Simply you have to attach the output with this media out and done. Here you have the new typography. You can simply customize it, change the text if you want. Just like this, and then go to the edit page and here we have the new title animation. Perfect. So this is the first one that we have created and this is the second one. Perfect. Now let's have a look. Just turn on the loop button, go to very first frame of this animation, hit Control F to full screen and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.